When Ella was diagnosed with type 1 diabetes, we realized that our lives were gonna be difficult. When you have a child that's got type 1 diabetes, their pancreas doesn't work. And you, the parent, have to become that pancreas. You're making hundreds of decisions a day for your child. You've sort of got a life sentence in that you're gonna have to get up 3 or 4 times a night to keep your child safe. You're making decisions in the middle of the night when you're tired. You make a slight decision not to do something, you could potentially harm your child. When I first saw Scott and Dana's post about the artificial pancreas being able to control blood sugars, it's like, why isn't this on the market?
So most of them are from running. So these are from 5K, and this is from the Seafarer Torchlight Run, a medal I got at one of the karate tournaments.
Ella is one of 200,000 children in the US diagnosed with type 1 diabetes. It's a relentless disease. And few people know that better than Dana Lewis.
Okay.
You have the CGMs?
I've got the CGMs. Do you have sugar?
Yeah, I do.
I was diagnosed with type 1 diabetes my freshman year of high school, which made it very, very hard to deal with. It's an autoimmune disease. We don't know exactly what causes it, but the body starts attacking itself and you no longer produce insulin. People with diabetes are always planning ahead. Even if on the weekend I wanted to sleep in, I still had to wake up at the same time, take that insulin, and then go back to sleep. If I slept through the blood sugar monitor going off, I could potentially end up in a coma. I actually built a safety plan with my mom, which was that she would text me every morning and say, "Are you awake?" Which was not just, "Are you awake?" but really, "Are you alive? Are you okay? Do you have any problems going on?" I used different kinds of technology from different manufacturers, and they all had the same problem, which was me not being able to hear the alarm.
Well, we have to fix that. So the fact that it doesn't respond at all to a single down click.
Is that just broken
on the
software?
Okay. It's something about the timing that's messed up.
When I first met Scott, he asked a lot of the same questions. Okay, how does the pump work? How does the CGM? Do they talk to each other? He was expecting the data from one device to go to the other, but he's like, why doesn't that work? About 6 months later, we stumbled across a gentleman named John Kostick, who is a parent of a child with diabetes. He had figured out how to reverse engineer the software so he could pull the data off and send it to the cloud. We're like, if we could use that, we could then build the system, send the data to my phone, and make a louder alarm. Wouldn't that be great? Our goal was just make louder alarms, but we ended up stumbling our way into building an artificial pancreas. Our artificial pancreas consists of a few components. It's the insulin pump and the continuous glucose monitor. And what we do is we add a small computer with a radio stick and a battery that bridges the gap and becomes the communication device between the pump and the CGM. So the small rig, as we call it, the computer and the radio stick together, reads data from the insulin pump. It reads data from the continuous glucose monitor, maps the prediction into the future with our algorithm and says, here's what's gonna happen, here's what action you need to take as a result. But instead of alerting me as the human, it automatically closes the loop and sends the command back to the insulin pump and raises or reduces the insulin amount. Then it reads the blood sugar again and does that same math over and over again. It's making hundreds of decisions a day for me.
So Dana took that design and did what any self-respecting tinkerer would do. She put it on the internet for free. And she called it the Open Artificial Pancreas System, or OpenAPS for short.
Not only has this changed my life, but to know that it's making a difference for other people's lives too. It's changing the family dynamic and making it just so much easier for them to live with diabetes.
So yeah, she still has a fair amount of IOB.
Yeah.
And she still has a fair amount of carbs, yeah. So this is actually fairly perfect.
It's doing the right thing.
So normally, I would have to be sweating this and worried about, okay, she was low earlier this morning. Now do I need to give her a whole bunch of insulin to be able to make up for that? I don't have to worry about it anymore because the artificial pancreas is going to continue to monitor the situation, figure out when she's going to hit that crest even before I would be able to visually see it. That's the really cool part.
Pizza was always a challenging food in order to have a pizza meal. That would usually mean multiple shots. No 8 or 9 year old kid is excited about multiple shots. OpenAPS is, you know, it's coming in and giving her extra insulin. She's still gonna have pretty stable blood sugar. We're all still gonna sleep. And so it becomes less of a big event to have a meal like that. it's not a big deal to deal with it.
The way that healthcare companies have been created, they haven't necessarily adopted their practices to match the speed at which we can innovate with technology. And that's why you see the widening gap in the timeline between what's being done in DIY and what's being done commercially. We need this technology desperately, and it's saving lives and giving incredible outcomes. Now waiting is a choice. We used to be forced to wait and just accept the status quo, but now the choice to not DIY is a choice to wait. We didn't have those choices before, and that's just an incredible difference.